No, I got the other one. But I mean, he knew, I didn't. You know, I couldn't tell.
On the last sitting, I was going to suggest possibility of bringing the corgis in, but whether they would have been able to be still, I don't know what they're like.
Oh, no, that's just one of them would.
Yes? Are they easy to train?
Yes, they're healers. You know, they're cattle dogs.
Yeah.
So they bite. They chase people. Depends who they chase, though. Well, the sentries used to have a bad time.
Yes. Do they chase them?
The present lot don't, but they did, yes. I think if somebody stamps and threatens you with a big stick, you know, when they go past, it's rather a natural reaction for a dog to...
Gosh, in my time in animal hospital, we saw the cases of animal neglect and cruelty to animals.
It was like the lady who had 30 animals in a house the other day.
Oh, 30? We've had a lady with, I think it was 125 cats and dogs and all living throughout the flat, yeah. Everywhere. And it was just appalling, so upsetting.
I suppose it still goes on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Some people go on holiday near their children by it too, don't they?
Oh, yes. That's better. I think I could move the watch face around that way, about down to
the other way. There's a watch.
That's it, perfect. Do you have a specific style of painting that you like?
Well, I mean, I suppose landscape is quite nice. I went to the Stubbs exhibition yesterday, which is lovely.
Amazing man he was. I read a little bit about his life just recently, and he studied horse anatomy.
Yes, well, all those studies are in the exhibition, which are fascinating.
I gather he used to get any horse died anywhere around him. He would get them to bring the carcass to his studio, and then he would dissect and study all the
muscles
and the way the bones worked and...
Just as well have been a butcher, mind you, really. But what he did, unfortunately, was that he experimented terribly with his canvases. And we've got one which is flaking off.
Mm.
You can't stop it.
Experimentation with the paint itself.
Mm. I don't know, he primed it wrong or something. It's terribly sad.
The pearls, I haven't looked at the pearls yet. Gosh, I need to start working out how to do this. They'll just put in a basic background colour and then do all the tiny highlights on the pearls later when it's all dry.
And they're not easy things to paint, I should
think. No, you've got to get each individual pearl has its own lustre and its own shape.
And there's a picture of Queen Alexandra at Sandringham. She's wearing a pearl thing all the way down her dress, which is rather grand. I've never tried that.
Do those jewels still exist?
Most of them, yes.
Do they get altered and change for today's fashion?
My grandmother altered a lot.
Do you ever have a desire to do the same sort of thing and change jewellery around for yourself?
I don't wear jewellery very much unless I have to. I mean, my grandmother gave me the tiara for a wedding present, and I only discovered after I succeeded and got into her safe that I realised she'd taken the base off it.
It was about that much taller, was it? Wow.
So it's back on again. I suppose she thought, you know, Charles only 21, doesn't need to have a very big one. And anyway, she had mountains of hair too, because she had that very tall way of wearing her hair, so she needed something very high. Have you painted me today?
I haven't done anything with you today, but I should do, shouldn't I, now that you're here? You can just look up at me again for a second.
Do you paint at home? I mean, you take it back and paint it.
I've been doing some stuff in my studio. I sometimes wake up at 3 a.m. and I can't sleep, so I've got daylight fluorescence in the studio so that the colour will be right.
And is the painting in the middle of the night as good as the painting other times of the day?
Yes, I think so, yes. You're remarkably well concentrated because there's no other distraction around of any sort. Well,
reaches
the
stage where...
I think so, yes. I've got that reference photo, which will be just perfect for all the background and for your face. I'd just like to take this opportunity of thanking you on behalf of the whole crew. Thank you so much.
I think it looks very nice. Very friendly, anyway.
Yes, that was my main aim.
Well, that's very clever, I think.
Hey, thank you. Thank you so much once again from us all.
That's fun. Well, thank you very much, Herbert.
Thank you.
Success.
Well, I'm so thrilled that Her Majesty likes the happy feel of it. Listen, thanks very much, all of you, for coming along today. Shall we unveil it? What do you think? All those in favour? Right, here we go. Take a big breath. 1, 2, 3, hup.